seen and gone through. Glad, sir.
Thank you, Bhavanji. Honorable jury members and friends, I am here to speak about a drama called the Operation Greener, which the Indian state has launched against its first citizen, the Adivasi, in the name of cleansing the Maoist. First, I would like to start with some cases, what actually drama is going on in the name of cleansing the Maoist. It was first launched in Kolhan region, East Singhum, most of you know, on 5th of March. The first were arrived to the places. This is a block called Sonua. And on there started operation from 7th of March. And what they did on 7th of March, there is a village called Kesel of Sonua village. So they went there, they entered in the house of Jagan Soy, Adivasi. They pushed them out, all the family members. They took all the food grain, wheat, rice, and other things. They mixed it and thrown on the floor. And they taken out their sarees and children's school dress, and also severely beaten Jagan's son. His name is Nirmal Soy. And then taken him to the police camp, and they questioned him. Then after some time they released. This was the first incident of the cleansing the Maoist. Second case is, this also took place the same day on 7th of May in Temna village. In Temna village, same thing they did. They entered in the house of Marcus Lugun. They scattered five bags of firing on the floor, and they taken out all the household things, and including BPL card. So the family doesn't have anything to survive. Third case, it took place, there was an accident, took place on 22nd of March. This is in Kolhan region, in Chowka. This comes in Chandi. There was some attacks in the sponge iron factory. We don't know who did that. But they said this attack was done by the Maoists. So they started operation. In that region, there is a village called Hesakocha. They started operation in Hesakocha and adjoining area. So there is another village called Barabeda. And Nirmal Hasapurti, this is the man who collected firewood. He sold it in the market and bought some rice in a bag, and he was going back to home so that he could feed his children and family members. But in between on the way, the security forces took the rice and him also to the camp, alleging him that this rice you are taking for the Maoist. Then they severely beaten him, and also they called all the villagers to the military camp, and the DSP told them that you people feed the Maoist, also conduct meeting with them and help them. So stop doing these things, otherwise we will do whatever we have to do. So this kind of story, you know, you will get each and every village where this so-called drama, the Operation Green Hand, is going on. Friends, and what are other things happening? Even guests are not allowed in some villages to go. If you have some guests, then you must get permission from the police, from the security person, that some guests are coming to your house. Then only they will allow. What kind of Operation Green Hand is going on, we don't understand. Another thing is festival. You know, Father Elias already explained about festival. And this Baha means flower. Baha is the festival, and in Urao it is called Sarhul, Khadi. In Baha is the really one auspicious festival of the Santhal. So what they do, they actually, this is a thanksgiving festival to the God. Well, because God gives everything. In this season, in the spring season, this is start of flower collecting of Goa and all. So the tradition is, before, unless they offer this first flower to the supernatural god, no community is allowed to collect the minor forest produces in the forest. But this time, in this, where this Operation Green Hand drama is going on, Adivasis, Santhal Adivasis are not allowed to celebrate this festival. Can you imagine? This is what R.P. Chidambaram, the corporate home minister, doing with the Adivasis, the first citizen of this country. Another thing, this police forces, they are conducting survey in each and every village in Rania and other places. Rania, where Arsenal Mittal Company has proposed a steel plant of 12 mega MT. So, what is happening? They are conducting survey in every village. How many members in that family? How much water they need? How much food they need? They are questioning Adivasis. Why you are taking 35 kg of food grain from PDSO? Because there is only 2 members in your family, 3 members in your family. Why you need 10 buckets of water? You people are 3 or 4. So everything, you know, they are watching, they are monitoring everything. So our life is, you know, depend on them, their will. Whatever they want, we should behave like them. So this is what Operation Green Hand is going on. Similarly, that because of this, what are the major impact in Adivasi? First is that there is really a huge livelihood crisis. Because of fear, because there are this kind of incident taking place, Adivasis are fear, so they are not going to the forest for collecting minor forest produce. Even they are not going to collect this firewood. They assume that if we go to the forest, they will kill us and they will show that, oh, we have, you know, hunted one Maoist. And that will be recorded in the paper of security forces. So they are not going to the forest. And another thing is that this is the, you know, prime time of collection of the forest produces, like Mahua and Chiranji. And this time they are not collecting. That means livelihood crisis will deepen, because they would not have anything to eat. That is one impact. Second is village economy. We have seen that it's crashing. Because if you go to the rural market, you will hardly find people. You won't find them because there is nothing. They will collect something in forest, then they will come to sell in the market. Then in return they can buy food grain and other things. But they have nothing to sell. Why should they go to market? That means slowly they are hitting, these forces are hitting the rural economy. And you will see after maybe within next 6 months that rural economy will crash, especially of the Adivasi. And third thing is that their mobility. You have heard that Adivasi are freedom lovers. They don't want to be slaves. They don't know. We don't know about slavery, because we were never slaves. But now freedom has been snatched. Even if you move in some, you know, roads, everywhere you will see some or other forces. So they will question, they will check you. Because of that, now total mobility in several areas have stopped. People are not dare to go out of the village. Because they say if you go, then suddenly they will blame village that you are Maoist. And the fourth thing is that democratic rights. This is called India is the largest democratic country in the world. But is it so? Our democratic rights have been taken away. The Adivasis, they had, you know, protested. They have come up with a rally on 19th of March against the Operation Green Hand. They said, we don't need Operation Green Hand because there is no such Maoist in our area. This happened in the Itki block. But then what DSP said? DSP told us they created such a situation so that people run away. So some people definitely. In 3,000, around 1,000 people ran away, and rest of the people were there. And he said that you people have not come up here on their own, but Maoists have sent you to to protest against the oppression beneath them. Can you imagine? The Adivasi, whom one Maoist will send, the Adivasi, we have 230 years of glorious resistance against the injustice. It starts from the Tilkamanji, Baba Tilkamanji, who said that who are you Britishers? Land is given by us to by our God. Who are you to ask revenue from us? This is not your. The state has not given us anything. This land is given by the God. And that struggle continued, followed by Birsa Munda and Tana Bharat, and still continuing. Just we are saying we don't need steel, we need food grain. This is what we are saying. We don't want to give our land. We don't need steel. We need food grain. Nothing else. But because of this crime, this is crime for them, no? So our democratic space has been totally seized by the oppression green hand. Fifth impact is right to education. I just laugh. Or I laugh because on first of April, Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh addressed to the nation. He was happy. He said, this is a historical moment. On the same day, there were many schools who were, you know, closed only because security forces are there. And there were many schools who closed on that day only when Prime Minister of India was addressing to the nation. And this is the glorious day for him. But it is the worst day for us, the Adivasi. So what is happening in the schools? Even in exam was taking place, but there were security forces. Now our children, they fear to go to school. Many of them left going to the school. Their right to food, not only right to education, but they get midday meal. Now right to food is also denied to the children of this country. Are we Adivasi not the citizen of this country? We are the first citizen of this country. And why are you behaving with us like this? You have denied everything for the last 62 years or 63 years of independence, and that now you talk about bullshit. This Maoist? Who has brought this Maoist? This is not a long issue, not just 4 decades ago. When Rajiv Gandhi was there, he used to tell that only 15% money reaches to the villages. Now same Rahul Gandhi telling, what you people are doing sitting in the jail? Everyone is telling something. That means you are not doing, just enjoying the cream and nothing else. And then you speak about Maoist and say that all Adivasi who are protesting against multinational companies, you say all those are Maoist. So right to education, right to life, everything has been denied to our children. Sixth impact is that now migration has started in the villages. In some villages you cannot live. You have to migrate in some safe places, and this will also grow. So these are the impact what I see. I will speak about this, how this Operation Green Hunt is not for clinching the Maoist, but it is for establishing the corporate houses in those so-called Red Corridor. Red Corridor, it was not in the eyes of our so-called ruling elite before 90s. Before 90s, the Adivasi areas, we are told that these people are uncivilized. These areas are uncivilized. No one wanted to go to those areas. But after liberalization, those areas were propagated as a mineral corridor so that global market come. The multinationals should come to this country. And they came. And when they wanted this red corridor to convert into corporate corridor, but they were not able to convert this red mineral corridor into corporate corridor, they brought also a special economic zone. This act, no? A special economic zone in 2005. Why? Only to convert the mineral corridor into red corridor. But when they were here, and in 2008, in November somewhere, people attacked Buddha Bhattacharya, then this Maoist issue was brought to the national issue. It was made a national issue. Why? They were not able to establish a corporate corridor in those mineral corridor, so they propagated it as a red corridor. This is how politics comes in. So this is then when you declare those areas where Adivasi live as a red corridor, then you have license to kill them, get land clear and hand it over to the corporate. That is the simple logic. Why I say I have very good logic to prove it. Why I say that they want this mineral corridor to transfer into red corporate corridor. First, is that our home minister has a very good corporate link. He represented Enron Corporation in India. Second, he was the member of board of directors in Vedanta Company, and he also drew the salary $70,000 in 2003 before becoming the finance minister in 2004. Number one. Number two, 102 MOU have been signed in Jharkhand for the last 10 years, and only 30 small industries have been established till the date. And Arjun Munda, when he became second time chief minister of Jharkhand, what was his achievement for 1 year? He said that his biggest achievement was signing MOU with the ArcelorMittal company for establishing 12 MT ton steel plant in Jharkhand with an investment of 40,000 crores. And this plant hasn't come till the date because we the Adivasi don't want to give him land. Because we are telling him we don't want to eat your steel, we want to eat food grain. So then what they will do? They are not able to. We are protesting everywhere. MOUs are not coming. In between, you must have what our Prime Minister Manmohan Singh said. Maoist or Naxalite are threat to what? Investment climate. Friend, everything is linked to one or other thing. So this is why they are shouting lots on Maoist. Then now what? Just 1 week ago, Mr. P. Chidambaram said that Maoists are more dangerous than jihadi terrorists. Why? Because Maoists have interest on minerals, they are not allowing you in some places. But terrorists have no interest on minerals. So now today, they become less dangerous than Maoists. So, this is how, you know, why they die. Why Maoists are dangerous? So everything, I think you understand how everything has been linked. Next, if I state that how this event are taking place in Jharkhand, which clearly prove that Operation Green Hand has a very clear mining or mineral interest. Over the period of time, several times, state and also media keep us telling that Plamu region of Jharkhand is the home of Maoist. But Operation Green Hand, which they launched now, they did not launch in Plamu region. They launched this Operation Green Hand in Kolhan region, where most of the MOU has been signed for establishing steel plant, power plant, and other mining industry. Second thing, on 17th March, they launched one more operation, which is I call Operation Mineral Hunt. And this, they are conducting survey, aerial survey in Jharkhand, to find out in what are the places mineral is. So on one hand, you say that we are you know, carrying out operation to cleaning mountains. On the other hand, you also start same time operation to find out minerals. So what does it mean? Just after 10 days of launching this Operation Green Hand, POSCO, the second largest steel factory of the world, steel company of the world, declared, you know, announced that they are shifting their project to Jharkhand from Odisha. They were not interested earlier, but now Operation Green Hand is going on, and they must be assured by our corporate home minister Chidambaram that he would be helping them in establishing their company in Jharkhand. So they announced. Second thing, that there are also a series of meetings going on. On one hand, Operation Green Hand meeting is going on the next door, CM and other in official, they are meeting with the corporate people. So why two meetings together going on? And another thing is, now on 5th of April, you must have heard, Indian government clear the license to Mittal for mining. It was pending for such a long time, and now Operation Green Hand is going on again. License was clear. So the main aim of the Operation Green Hand is now they want to create livelihood crisis in the village, create insecurity, seize the freedom of the villages, terrorize the villages. So that at the end of the day, people will migrate with what is happening in Chhattisgarh. So once people is migrated from the villages, nobody will be there to protest against your corporate houses. So you will get comfortable chances to establish corporate houses in those areas. And I am sure you must remember that day will come when if all these MOUs which have been signed, if they are able to establish their plant in those areas, Mao will be nowhere in the national agenda. You must remember this. And till these corporate houses are able to, corporate shops are able to enter in those areas, this issue will continue. So, what are the solutions? Let me speak also that if this is the matter or this is the situation, friends, this is not the issue or matter of one or two days. This has been going on for last 230 years. And Indian state was never interested to address this because they did nothing for the Adivasi. What they did is only thing to sign their resources as much as they can. They have taken away, like in Jharkhand only, more than 22 lakhs acre of our land. Can you imagine? Even after we the Adivasi are determined to fight back. Second thing I would like to tell, that we have to understand that Adivasi, these are two different societies. One society who follows the living style of individual or individual based on individual living, and another society which is the Adivasi society, which is based on community living. So the thing is, can land and life come together? Cannot. And if you see the economic system, your economic system is based on greed and our economic system is based on need. Then if you have to address this issue, either we have to leave our need-based economic system and follow your greed-based economic system, go for huge corruption, kill our women who don't come with so huge dowry, and do whatever you people are doing. That is one way. Second thing is, you leave your greed and join us. We welcome you. You live with us, but really, election already told for the election, James Chopko, that how we collect as much as we need for a year. We don't collect for the 7th PD. And you collect for the 7th PD. So this is the difference, friend. I need per month maybe 1 or 2,000. For my survival, but your Mukesh Ambani, who is the business icon, needs or get 4 crore per month as a salary. Does he really need, or this is his greed? If you don't need this address, don't need this, you don't address this question, you won't be able to address the issue of Maoist or conflict over natural resources. Because this is really in need and greed in between. We our economy is based on need, so we don't harm the nature. So global warming, we have no contribution like that. So in global warming only you have contributed. So you have to think, you have to come back to need waste, not the greed waste. And we will not follow because we don't want to harm our nature. So even if you try, we will not follow you. So you have to think, if you want this sustain, this world to sustain, if you want you to sustain, your generation to sustain, then you have to think whether you should continue with the greed-based economic system or you should follow the need-based economic system. And second, also, I would emphasize that already other eminent speakers told that natural life and the artificial life. How? Just remember, we came in this morning, entered in the hall, and we saw that. How jhana inside? So this artificial life you follow. And we, the Adivasi, we live with the nature. We follow the natural thing. You come, you will see this kind of jhana in our forest. So you have to decide what kind of life you want. Then only you can speak or you can talk about how to address the problem. You have created all the problem. No, we never. So you have to think, why should we? We are doing what we are supposed to do. We are just saying that we don't want to give our land because we are the land of the, we are the son of the land. We are protecting and this land doesn't belong to us because this land has suffered from our ancestor. We are only trusted to this land and we want this land to continue for our generation. So we don't want to give anyone. But even after that, I would suggest one or two, if our corporate home minister P. Chidambaram can do, but he will never do. If you have to take the confidence of the people, you scrap all the MOUs which you have signed first, so that at least that would be first step, at least we believe that you are little bit honest to us, number one. Number two, give us the ownership right which our ancestors had. And because of paper, you were enough, you know, aap bahut chatur the, so you prepare the paper and said this is our forested land. So you give us the forest, this ownership land, because in paper you say that in Forest Right Act, no, what they said, that historic wrongs will be right. But on the other hand, they are handing over all those land to the corporate. On one hand, they speak of giving forest land to us. Right on forest land. On other hand, they are taking our land for the corporate. So that is second, ownership rights on natural resources. And third, of course, the legislation which we never prepare. Whatever legislation you have prepared in favor of us, implement. These three things I would suggest him. Even if, but I don't think that he will hear. But we are determined. We will fight back. Till our last breath, we will not give our life because we need food grade, not the steel. Thank you very much.